Well, let's assume Ed Brown built his home with the belief he'd someday have to go off the grid and wait out any officials who wanted to capture him. Now federal marshals are waiting to see if the Browns are truly ready to rough it.
The only noise around Ed and Elaine Brown's property now are the songs of birds, no longer the hum of power lines. Federal authorities say they've taken further measures to squeeze the couple holed up in their Plainfield home going on 7 weeks.
We have seized their phones and internet service, and 2 days ago we also shut off their power. It's a continuing effort to move them along to understand that they need to do the right thing, and that is surrender to us.
The idea is to take away the couple's creature comforts until they surrender to authorities. The Browns have added solar and wind power generators and reinforced concrete walls to their home. The couple was convicted in absentia of income tax evasion this spring and have refused to come out.
The Browns have both alternative energy and battery power to draw upon to keep their property running. But authorities don't believe the equipment they have is capable of powering a building that size for an extended period of time.
Last week, a small army of law enforcement paraded through Plainfield. U.S. Marshal Steve Monier says it wasn't the makings of a raid, only a surveillance mission. Brown predicted that they would try to take him by force.
Do I look like I'm dangerous? But I could be. I could be.
Monier says they have no interest in raiding the house or harming the Browns. They just want justice served.
It's unfortunate that the Browns are taking this position because, you know, they have been through the process and there's been an outcome and they need to surrender.
Monier says they're aware waiting out the Browns could take many months, but time is on their side. He hopes after a summer without AC and maybe even a winter without heat, serving their prison terms will seem like an agreeable option. Kevin Flynn, WMUR News 9.